American woman who'd walked in there. She should have been treated the same way as if this had, if they had known this woman, Oprah Winfrey, could afford the bag. I mean, she shouldn't have been treated that way just because of her race. So, you know, we still live in a day and age where it is something that people are completely stuck on, and still to this day have no, you know, some of them are just so completely living in the past that they still have no idea how retarded they are, or ridiculous they are, excuse me, how ridiculous they are, they're acting, and how sad they are, and they're on the wrong side of history. And, you know, I hear plenty of people on online who talk about race and talk about, you know, race and people of different races in a bad way and act as if people of different races are somehow inferior. And that gets very tiring to me, just as it does people treating gay people in the same way, treating us like we are inferior to heterosexuals simply because we're different. And to me, what makes people different is what makes people interesting. I would hate to live in a world where we were all heterosexual. First of all, if we were all heterosexual, think about how few hairdressers there would be. The movie industry would be completely distraught and it would have very low quality of set design, of writing, of production, of acting, of directing. I mean, these things are things that are the domain of many gay people, whether you know it or realize it or not. And without gay people, your life would be very different. Our lives would be very different. So I think it's important for people to acknowledge when they think about gays and lesbians or, you know, people of different races, to understand and acknowledge what that race or that culture or, you know, sexual orientation has brought to the world and contributed to the world. All races, all people of all sexual orientations, all religions, everything have contributed something positive in some way or another to the world. You know, so it's not like you can just say someone's one thing and therefore they are worthless. No, all of us have something to contribute and all of us are important to the larger fabric of society, to the larger fabric of what is our world, what makes up our world, you know? So hopefully that makes sense and you understand what I'm saying. So I'm going to take a quick break, come back, and if you want to call in, the number's 214-377-0481. I'm happy to talk to you. We're going to play some music, and we'll be right back. call into the show. You can call in to... Sorry about that, everybody. You can dial into my show at 204-477-0401. Sorry, I'm having technical difficulties, apparently. Sorry about that. So if you want to call in the show, that number is 214-377-0481. Feel free to call in and chat with me if you want to. If you don't, you can sit back and listen. So anyway, sorry about the technical difficulties. I keep trying to remember how to do things right on here. I keep forgetting sometimes because it's a little more complicated than what I'm used to. So I apologize if I'm having some fails on the show here. So what I was talking about earlier was judgment and looking at things that way. But lately, I've been thinking a lot about spirituality and thinking about how I feel about that in general. And so I wanted to talk a little bit about that because I feel like I don't talk about it as much as I used to on my show. And, you know, I've often said that, you know, you could call me an atheist, but I'm not really an atheist because I actually have spiritual beliefs. So I'm certainly not an atheist. I'm more of a humanist, if you want to call it that. And humanists basically believe that there could potentially be a God. There could potentially be some sort of higher entity. We're not saying that there isn't. But if there is a God, that we believe that he doesn't interfere with everyday lives of humans. So, for example, if you believe in the Big Bang Theory, then you might believe, okay, which I do, if you believe in the Big Bang Theory, we don't know what happened before the Big Bang, but whatever happened after it, that was it. God set in motion everything, and then everything just happened as it was going to happen. Humanity evolved, you know, dinosaurs evolved, and humanity evolved, and so on. So it was never... something where God is sitting around, as I've always said, on a throne, looking at us and judging us and making judgments on who we are as humans. Creating us is sort of a fluke of nature. What happens to us, I think. I don't think we're created necessarily by anything. I think we just sort of evolved and, you know, we're born and then we live. So the question always becomes, you know, but what I was going to say, humanists believe that we as humans are able to somewhat govern our own lives without the need of a supreme being. Even if there is a supreme being, we don't believe it's necessary for that being to interfere with our lives in order for us to govern ourselves. Because a lot of times people will say to atheists who are atheists, you know, they'll say, well, atheists don't believe in anything, so they must have horrible morality. And of course, that's ridiculous. Of course, that's not true. I know many atheists who are really wonderful people and give tons to charity and are just nice, wonderful, great people. But the point of humanism is like, without God, you still are going to know that you don't murder each other, that you don't steal, that you're still going to have a morality based on humanistic views, meaning humans can determine for themselves what is and isn't right and that sort of thing. And that's what that's where the morality comes from. So you don't need a religion to tell you what to believe. You can know innately as a human being what is and isn't right and what is and isn't wrong. What is and isn't right and wrong, sorry. So I think that a lot of times that gets kind of lost in the fray when you're talking about other belief systems other than you know, the typical Christianity or whatever. But I also have a lot of very kind of Eastern philosophy type views on religion or spirituality. I was almost going to be a Buddhist.